Hi, my name is Ashit Kumar Shivastu. I'm an assistant professor of law at National Law University, Odisha. I'm offering courses on constitutional law and on data protection law. I'm also offering a course on basics of Indian constitution at Odisha State Open University. In pursuance to our last lecture, I shall be discussing about citizenship today. What is the idea of citizenship, as to why do we require it, and what is the purpose of having the idea of a permanent settlement? Keep in mind, a good citizen, a person who is a citizen of a particular country, gets benefits of that country also. He can be appointed as the President of India, the Supreme Court judge, or judge of a High Court also. If you're not a citizen of this particular country, you're immune to all these services. Keep in mind, in the initial stage, the idea of citizenship brought in the idea of having an interest in a country. So, with the idea of citizenship, you have a right to vote. With the idea of citizenship, you can have a say. With the idea of citizenship, you have a recognition that, you know what, you are bestowed with certain rights. Now, under the Indian Constitution, there are six articles dealing with the idea of citizenship. That is basically part 2 of Indian Constitution, ranging from Article 5 till Article 11. Article 5 talks about having citizenship at the commencement of the Constitution. It lays down certain guidelines as to when a person can be regarded as a part of Indian country. For that very particular purpose, the first condition is that he must have a domicile in the country of India. The idea of domicile represents the idea of animus mendendi. That's the idea of staying back to a particular country. That you will stay back in this country for a longer period. It's a much more harder term as compared to the idea of residentship. Now, the first condition Article 5 is that you must have a domicile in India. The second condition is you must be born in India. The third condition is either of your parents should be born in India, or you must be having a residentship in India for a period of 5 years immediately before the commencement of the Constitution. That's Article 5. Article 6 of Indian Constitution deals with those people who have migrated to the territory of India from Pakistan. It says, notwithstanding anything contained in Article 5, any person who has migrated to the territory of India from the territory of Pakistan can be regarded as part of India, provided he has migrated, he or his parents or his grandparents were born in India, as defined in Government of India Act 1935, and he must have come before the date of 19 July 1948. That's the date when the certificates for permanent resettlement was issued by the Government of India. Or if they migrate after 19 July 1948, they must be registered as a citizen of India when an official under the Government of India Provincial Act. The other condition is they must have lived in India for a period of 6 months prior to the commencement of the Constitution. That's Article 6 for us. Now we move to Article 7. Article 7 talks about those people who have migrated to the territory of Pakistan now, but once they come back to India, can they be regarded as part of India or not? So, if any person who has migrated to the territory of Pakistan after first day of March 1947, he shall not be regarded as a part of India. But if any citizen who has migrated up to first day of March 1947, he can be part of India, provided he comes back and he is registered as a citizen by an official of the Government of India. Article 8 talks about people who are living outside but were born in India. Any person who was born in India, either of his parents who were born in India, either of his grandparents were born in India, as defined in Government of India Act 1935, can be regarded as a part of India, provided he is registered by a consular representative of India in that particular country. Article 9 talks about the idea of losing out your citizenship. If any person who acquires a citizenship of another country shall cease to be a member of India. The idea of India is basically to have one single citizenship. Anyone who takes a citizenship of other country shall not be part of India anymore. Article 10 talks about the continuance of citizenship. Once you have acquired a citizenship of India, it shall continue for till your life. Article 11 talks about making of a law. We already have a law for dealing with the idea of citizenship. The law is Citizenship Act 1955. Under that particular act, we have Section 3, 5 and 6 dealing with the idea of as to how one can acquire the citizenship of India. Under this particular lecture, we shall have discussed the idea of citizenship in India. In the next lecture, we shall discuss about the idea of amendments. For now, thank you very much.